a very pleasant morning to respected sisters, teachers, dear parents, and everyone witnessing us at this very moment. Today, we the friends of Mary Watch are going to present before you the digital assembly on the topic, Be Kind and Merciful Towards the Poor and Do Not Call Them Beggar.
Friends, now our beautiful flowers from the Garden of Assembly are going to present before you all the welcome dance. So let's enjoy.
We gather here to tell you on this very special day, we're all so very happy to wish and to you say.
God's blessings through this prayer dance.
Reading from the Holy Quran. Serve God and do not associate anything with God. And be good to your parents and relatives and to orphans and paupers and to neighbors close by and neighbors remote. And the companion at your side, for God does not love the arrogant, the boastful. Verse 36.
From Srimad Bhagavad Gita, you have a right to perform your prescribed duty, but you are not entitled to the fruits of action. Never consider yourself the cause of the result of your activities and never be attached to not doing your duty. Chapter 2, text 47.
Reading from Guru Granth Sahib. There is one God, His name is Truth. He is the Creator. He is without fear and without hate. He is beyond time, immortal. His spirit pervades the universe. By the grace you shall worship Him. Rahat 1 verse 3.
Reading from Holy Bible. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Matthew 5, 3 to 12.
A great father of nation, Shri Mahatma Gandhi Ji, has very beautifully said, poverty is the worst form of violence. Caring for the poor and the needy people and helping them is a very noble service. By helping the poor and the needy people, we can make this world a better place for them to live in. If we really want the growth of this world, then we should and we must uplift the poor and the needy people by helping them. We don't need to have deep pockets and to be very rich to help the poor, the needy and the hungry ones. Only we need is to have a heart full of love, compassion, pity, sympathy and sensitivity, which can actually understand their suffering and agony. As it is greatly said by our beloved founders, Venerable Mother Mary Ward, be kind and be merciful towards the poor and never call them beggar. She loved the poor, not only the materially poor, but also the spiritually poor. She taught us the compassionate living, in which we should always consider the poor and the needy people. To love the poor, live, die, and rise with them was all the aim of Mother Mary Ward. She followed the path of Christ and lived not just for herself, but for others. So today, let's take a vow that we will do our best to remove poverty completely from our nation. Thank you.
It's time now when our tiny dot will present before you all an inspiring story through their act, that how our founders, Venerable Mother Mary Ward, inspired us to be merciful and compassionate towards everyone since her early childhood.
Grandma, where are you going?
I am going to see the prisoners, dear. They suffer a lot.
Oh, Grandma, you look so sad. How do you know they suffer so much?
But I myself was in a prison for 14 years for being a Catholic.
Oh, what are you carrying in that basket, Grandma?
This is some food for the prisoners. They get so little to eat.
Okay, Grandma, take my little checks also for them.
Jump, my sweet child.
Dance is the hidden language of the soul. Come on, let's enjoy an action dance.
Happiness is something if you give it away. You give it away. You give it away. Happiness is something if you give it away, then it comes right back to you. Oh, it's just like a magic penny. Hold on tight and you won't get any. Lend it, spend it, give it away, then it comes right back.
Buddha spread the word that on a particular day, he would accept donations for charity with his own hands. He requested everyone to come with any offerings they wished to be distributed to the poor. On the day of donations, Buddha sat under a tree to accept offerings. The great king Bimbisara was the first to offer incredible gifts, precious jewels, gold coins, large quantities of foods, and deeds of lands and houses. Buddha accepted all the gifts with his one hand. Prince Ajatasattu followed with gifts that were equally valuable. Buddha again received all the gifts with his one hand. After this, many kings, nobles and merchants presented gifts to Buddha. Buddha accepted all the gifts with his one hand. After all the kings were done giving their offerings, an old woman arrived. She greeted Buddha and said eagerly,
"Enlightened one, I heard about your receiving gifts only today. I am a poor woman and have nothing. When I heard the news, I was eating this pomegranate and had eaten only half. I have nothing else to give, so I brought along only my half of pomegranate."
Buddha extended both his hands to receive the half pomegranate. This astonished everyone present there. Some of the kings were even offended. Taking initiative, one of the kings approached Buddha and asked respectfully,
"Dear Lord, why did you receive a gift which was only half pomegranate with both hands? And all of our gifts only with one hand, her gift pales in comparison to our gifts. O kings, we all give expensive gifts indeed, but none of you give even a tenth of what you have. And even what you gave, your motives were more for glory rather than charity. This woman gave her all, and that too happily. Her intentions were so magnanimous that I definitely needed both my hands to accept her offering.
Now, what I can take away from this story is that the purity of your intention matters more than magnitude of your action. Just because you are doing huge deeds does not make you superior to others. Another lesson that can be learned is that if you want to do something, then really seek it and go after it with all you have. You must not doubt your capacity or need and compare that with others. Just trust yourself and give your cause all that have.
Friends, let's hear and enjoy the moment with a melodious song.
किसी की मुस्कुराहटों पे हो निसार, किसी का दर्द मिल सके तो ले उधार, किसी के वास्ते हो तेरे दिल में प्यार।
जीना इसी का नाम है,
किसी की मुस्कुराहटों पे हो निसार, किसी का दर्द मिल सके तो ले उधार, रास्ते हो तेरे दिल में प्यार।
जीना इसी का नाम है, माना अपनी जेब से फकीर है, फिर भी आज दिल के हम अमीर है। माना अपनी जेब से फकीर है, फिर भी आज दिल के हम अमीर है।
मिटे जो प्यार के लिए वो जिंदगी, जले बहार के लिए वो जिंदगी। किसी को हो ना हो हमें तो ऐतबार,
जीना इसी का नाम है, रिश्ता दिल से जीते ऐतबार का, जिंदा है हम इसी नाम प्यार का, रिश्ता दिल से जीते ऐतबार का,
नामदार का। उम्र के भी किसी को याद आएंगे, किसी के आंसुओं में मुस्कुराएंगे, कहेगा फूल हर कली से बार बार,
जीना इसी का नाम है।
Dance is the joy of movement and the heart of life. With this thought, here comes our graceful dancers to perform a beautiful dance.
Tum ta, 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 tum कजले वाली दूर बड़ी दिवाली दीवे ढूंढे अखिया दिल वाले घोंसले में पंछी बना के यारो हमने
performance.
No salutation to God is complete without serving all His creations, especially the poor and the needy. Let us take a pledge to make this fight against poverty a mission. Now, before we conclude, I would like to present a slideshow to give you a glimpse of the efforts that we, the Friends of Mary Ward, SMC Prayagraj, have taken. We don't need to have deep pockets or be rich to help the needy, the poor and the hungry. We need to have an heart. We can't help everyone, but everyone can help someone. We make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give. Let us follow the teachings of our foundress. Be merciful towards the poor and do not call them beggars. They need our love and care. Spread kindness, spread happiness.
Through the eyes of gratitude, everything is American.
Women in time to come will do much. This maxim of Mother Mary Ward has been reiterated in the classes and assemblies of SMC time and again. I, Swarnam Agarwal, Batch 2019, am happy to share some learnings from the life of Mother Mary Ward and the sisters. St. Mary's Convent Inter College strives to groom its students to become empowered women of the future. The legacy of Mother Mary Ward is carried on by the school under the able guidance of the CJ sisters. The holistic education and learning instill a student with self-belief and self-confidence. The diverse background of students helps develop a mutual understanding and respect for all fellow human beings, irrespective of their social backgrounds. The academics and the co-curricular activities, along with a spiritual education, shapes up the girls of SMC to grow into independent women. The value education classes, the long assemblies, and the various cultural programs provide a space for students to become spiritually and morally oriented and to showcase their talents and explore various fields and subjects. The various acts of charities and visits to the charitable homes increases the awareness of the students and develops a mutual kindness among them. Last but not the least, the students of SMC stand out from the crowd owing to the leadership skills and the self-belief imparted during their school life. The learnings and experiences that the students have within the premises of SMC plays a significant role in the transition into the world beyond school, that is, the so-called real world. The students are imbued with the self-belief that makes them the torchbearers of change in whichever field or careers that they choose to pursue. Mother Mary Ward was a pioneer of women's education. The girls of SMC become the women alumni who are pioneers in their respective fields.
On behalf of entire fraternity of the school management team, it is a great honor and privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this memorable occasion. Let me first of all start by giving glory to the Almighty God for making today's assembly a resounding success. First and foremost, I thank our Provincial Sister Shweta, our Principal Sister Jyoti, our Vice Principal Sister Surbhi for being the mentor who stimulated us to do our best. My heartfelt thanks to our Headmistress Sister Martha for your valuable contribution, guidance and encouragement in all our efforts. Last but not the least, I thank to my all teachers, parents and my dear friends for your cooperation in making this assembly a resounding success. Once again, I thank you all for your efforts. Thank